my name is Lesedi Dawn. Welcome back to my channel. If you are new here, hello. If you are a long time subscriber, thank you so much for the love and thank you for coming back. In today's video, we are going to be talking about 5 digital side hustles that you can get started on ASAP. Now, you're well aware that the world has changed. We are now obviously living in a whole new world, new normal. So I'm not going to list side hustles that you already know but you can't put into place right now because of social distancing and all of that. So I'm going to give you 5 digital side hustles that you can begin to profit from the comfort of your home. Side hustle number 1, personal shopping. People love convenience and many are actually afraid to go out to the shops right now, or perhaps they don't really have as much time, you know, with everyone working from home. Our personal lives and our work lives have kind of like mixed up, therefore we are not finding ourselves having as much time as we used to. Or, you know, you'd be leaving the office on your way home, passing the shops, whether it's just for groceries, your essentials, or some other forms of personal shopping. So if you are someone that loves to shop, whether, like I said, it could be for food, it could be for fashion or clothing items, this could be a side hustle that you could potentially look into, where you do the shopping for people and you have the items delivered to their homes. Side hustle number 2, freelancing. Obviously, depending on what your skill sets are, when you are a freelancer, you can get gigs online. There's different websites such as Fiverr and Upwork. These are online platforms that you can sign up to, and obviously, you know, if someone is looking for a particular skill set, or they're looking for someone to, you know, as a freelancer to work in a particular project, if you are putting yourself out there really well, then it's easier for people to find you. Obviously, like I said, this is dependent on your skill set. So whether you're into copywriting, you're into graphic design, or you're into social media or website design or website development, you're going to want to showcase that and make sure that your profile speaks highly of the work that you've done in the past. Having a portfolio does help in making you stand out. I can do a separate video as to how to get work, but yeah, having a portfolio is a great way to make sure that you stand out, and it builds a relationship and it builds some form of trust, obviously, because you know what you're doing, you've done it before. So potential clients are going to want to see that portfolio or work of evidence to show that you know what you're talking about and you do have the skill and you're not just taking them up arrive. So make sure that you get that in place. But like I said, 2 websites that you're going to want to check out is Fiverr and Upwork. Side hustle number 3, virtual assistant. If you are someone who is well organized, very, very good with their time management, has time, and has access to the internet, then this might be a side hustle that you could potentially look into. Obviously, how much you charge is entirely dependent on you, and what areas you sort of focus on as well is entirely dependent on you. As a virtual assistant, you could be one for an entrepreneur that might be too busy to organize meetings or their calendar, or for someone who's extremely busy and doesn't have time to, you know, merge their work life and their personal life. You could come in as a virtual assistant and make sure that, you know, there's a cohesive balance between the 2 separate calendars, so that there are never any clashes. And, you know, that particular individual, if they are so busy, maybe they might forget that it's their child's birthday. You'd obviously, as their virtual assistant, so sort of like a personal assistant, make sure that, you know, there's a cake on the day, that they're reminded that they need to go get a gift, and so on and so forth. Like I said, also, it will be highly dependent on areas that you want to focus on, whether just from a personal angle, or, you know, looking at someone who is in the business space and wants someone to just help them manage their calendar or run their errands for them. Side hustle number 4, online tutorials, or becoming an online tutor. If you're someone that used to get really good grades and, you know, you have a specific subject or model that, you know you enjoy, you're really great at economics, and, you know, first years are suffering, or second years are suffering with the economics, then you might be able to step in right here. You could help your peers out doing virtual online tutorials, so it doesn't necessarily have to be face-to-face interaction. or if you are someone that loves children and you know you really really love entry-level mathematics, then this could also be your area of focus. Just remember that depending on which group you want to focus on, your patience might be slightly tested, so just keep that in mind. So obviously this does require you to have a good internet connection, actually all of these, because all of these are online, like we just start there. You need to have good internet in order for you to do any of these five, you know, side hustles that I'm mentioning in this video. Make sure that you've got good internet, you've got the time to do the work that you say you're going to do, and you're not just promising and making empty promises. You gotta keep to your word, and you gotta market yourself really well as well, depending on which side hustle you wanna jump into. Side hustle number five, buying and reselling. Yes, I'm speaking about drop shipping. And if the concept sounds a little bit too technical, you could potentially look at how, for instance, right now, Insta boutiques are popping left, right, and center. Almost everyone has an Insta boutique, and there's nothing wrong with that. Yes, there might be quite a few of them out there. So what you're going to want to do is find a way to differentiate yourself from everyone else. Perhaps instead of selling dresses and blazers, you might look at a particular different space, perhaps focusing on athleisure or sportswear. That way, you know, you're standing out from the competition and you're offering something that is not as popular. So if this is something that interests you, you might want to look at, you know, online service providers or online platforms that sell these sort of merchandise, such as Amazon and Alibaba. And just keep in mind that when you are looking at dropshipping or buying and reselling, there might be an element where you are required to have minimum quantities. And obviously there tends to be lead times. Perhaps you might only get your stock in 2 weeks. So if you are setting up, you know, this sort of side hustle, keep that in mind so that you're able to communicate and make sure that you have the right amount of stock, and also you're also able to gauge what is required in the market or where the gap is, so that you're not necessarily just copying and pasting what someone else is doing and hoping that the same works for you. So find a niche, find a gap in the market so that you can then stamp in and, you know, make a mark and, you know, profit from that. Whatever your interest is, the opportunities are endless. That's it from me today. I hope that you found this video very insightful. I shared five digital side hustles that you can get started on in 2021. Which one will it be? You let me know in the comment section. If you enjoyed this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. If you are new here and you honestly don't even know how you ended up on this channel, don't forget to subscribe. Clearly, you enjoyed this kind of content. The fact that you made it to the end and you are not yet subscribed, hit the subscribe button. Till next time, bye.